ahead with Samresh. Samresh will be talking to us on studying the airflow in during COVID. Dr. Yeah. Samresh, please.
Thank you. Thanks again for inviting me for this session. And this is a little bit of a break from mainstream ophthalmology. We've all had a bad time in COVID. I don't think there's anyone who can, you know, argue that at any level. And we've had so many options and so many confusing ideas from everyone. Put a, you know, one of those blue devices, wear a PPE, wear this sort of mask, double tape it, put a face shield. But we don't know what worked. We don't know how we have still survived, how we are still sitting over here. Some of us caught it in the first wave, some of us caught it in the third wave. So we decided that during the COVID time, at the peak of it, we wanted to understand in our clinic as to what's happening when the patient walks into the clinic and what puts us at risk in an ophthalmic practice, particularly. According to WHO, this is the number of healthcare workers that could have died from COVID. And this is just one virus that came out, and God knows what's happening and where the world is heading. So it's very important we understand what's going on with this scenario. We are at close proximity to the patient all the time. And we don't know in the shadows what's lurking behind, because we talk, we converse, patients cough, patients sneeze while they're there. And there is so much transmission of aerosol, not only from the patient towards us, but we can be a source of infection for the patient as well. So it's risk both ways, and it's important that we understand what's happening. A lot of studies have been done, some combining infrared light where they look at the heat movement, and again, many sorts of infrared cameras that can monitor if the patient is sneezing or the patient is hot and inflamed at certain areas. But for us, what was important was to understand the airflow, because it was the air that was playing a crucial role for us at that point in time, and may again, once a variant comes out, play a role for us, and who knows. So we looked up literature, we looked up different techniques, and this is what came up. Schlieren is a way of photography which images air movement. Otherwise, unseen air, that you must have seen some videos flowing in when you see people sneezing and coughing, you can see air going, but it's all experimental. We decided to do a DIY setup in the clinic and see what's happening in the OPD, right on the slit lamp, see what's happening in the OR when the patient is lying down on the table. Because we don't know, in a clinical setup, in a laboratory setting or an optical bench, life is different. In a real life scenario, it's different. So this is how it works. There's a point light source that falls on a big telescopic mirror. The light is reflected back. This is the same thing in our clinical scenario. There's a small LED light source and there's a big telescopic mirror. So how it goes is the light comes out of this. Use a small LED bulb and then make a small pinhole and by attaching one of those tapes, and then the light falls back touching the mirror telescope, goes onto a blade, and the blade bisects the light. So only half of that stream of light that's coming goes back into the camera, as you can see in this animation over here, comes back, one half is stopped, and the deflected half goes into an SLR camera that captures the air movement. This is just to show you by defocusing how we've captured the light. And this is again one of our captures from initial our clinical setting to see this is how air would look, you know. And it's beautiful to see air. But when we see in an OPD, in a close proximity, slit lamp is what you wanted to evaluate. That's Dr. Vaishali who's demonstrating. You can see there is such free flow of air happening. It's moving up and down. When the patient talks, it gets far more advanced. And because of the limited view of the telescopic mirror, we could only image so much. But if we can see it going in, it's going towards you and it's reaching your airflow system as well. If you put a mask, there is some dampening, particularly with an N95 mask. But it's not enough. So if the patient is coughing, there is still leak, but the leak is dampened. So it's better. It's not completely gone. But what is worse is an ill-fitting mask. And I wanted to notice over here, this is an N95 where that metal tape on the top has not been completely tightened up. And this is more risky because it's now giving a jet of air that's moving towards you. So not wearing a mask or wearing a loosely fitted mask, or when those patients pull down their mask to talk to you, is much worse because it's putting you at a bigger risk. This is the area of leakage for us. Surgical mask, N95 mask, anything where you have a tape but you're not doing it, this is where leakage is happening from. So what we started doing was, we started taping all our patients in the clinic. Anybody that walks into the OPD, we tell them, we're going to tape you. Once you tape the patient's mask and your mask, it reduces significantly the amount of load that you have coming towards you. It's a simple technique, it works beautifully. The tape is difficult to take out because it's that 3M surgical tape. So you tell the patient that go slow, don't pull out your skin along, because a few patients complained, but it worked for us. So the first lesson we learned was tape the mask. This is on the slit lamp. You can see there is so much of movement. It's a no-brainer. You know, if the patient is breathing in and out, there's so much of movement, and it was quite striking to see. And obviously barriers work. So this is a patient, this is us using a face shield, so impractical for an ophthalmology practice, but a but a breath plate, a larger size breath plate. So this came with our LASIK machine. We put it on all our slit lamps because this completely cuts you off from the patient. So mechanical barriers work, but you have to use them where you can use them, and it's not possible for all our situations. But the one thing that we saw was room air circulation. So this is one of our clinics, and this is where we wanted to understand how the room air will help or not help. So we put our slit lamps under the direct flow of an air conditioner. This is a ceiling-mounted air conditioner. And notice this. The patient is breathing. There's a loosely fitted mask. And we turn on the air conditioning. The moment you turn on the air conditioning, that's the draft that you see. Everything the patient breathes falls down. Nothing will reach towards the doctor, and everything starts to flow downwards. So very important lesson was a forceful downward draft of air, either a fan, preferably a pressurized air conditioner or a wall-mounted fan that can blow the air away from you towards the patient end or preferably down to the ground is a great tool. It's a simple, easy hack that you can use. We did the same thing in the operating room, and we weren't operating at that point in time, so we could pull in our, stuff. And there's so much of, you know how it works in an OR when you're a busy OR. So much movement is happening. People are moving. Patients come, go in and out. And no matter what the company says about air exchanges, there is far more, contamination that's happening during the surgery. So it's very important that we understand what goes on there too. Again, with the mask, there's a loose leakage. You can see this is an N95 mask, but it's patient's breath is causing some slight leakage. Again, if you tape the patient's mask, it's better because otherwise the jet is coming to your face if you're superiorly operating because it's coming right there and it's pretty scary to see that way. So adhesive tapes work. What works better than adhesive tapes is adhesive drapes. Drapes are excellent. So if you have a good big adhesive combination of a drape and you tighten it around the lids, there's no leakage that's going to happen. You might not want to tape the patient because they're already getting a little worked up with the surgery. But a laminar airflow is probably the best thing we saw. And the laminar airflow, if you put your entire surgical scenario under a laminar, as you can see over here, the draft is so strong that even if the patient tries to cough, we induce all sorts of sneezing maneuvers, nothing really comes out of there. This is the patient lying under a drape and nothing, there is no air movement. So a laminar airflow, if nothing else, is probably the best tool that you have in your clinic. If I could put it in an OPD during the pandemic time, I would have gone ahead and do it. We wrote this up and we sent it to the Journal of Cataract Refractive Surgery. But the ASCRS, even before the publication, said this is key takeaway messages, and they sent an email to all their members saying starting to adopt. It was a good thing that it was very well accepted, and they did not delay in coming up with recommendations based on our study. So just to brief it up, please have a snug fit of a mask. Right now is not the time. We are all sitting without masks, but who knows what's going to happen later. Please consider taping a mask, particularly in high-risk scenarios. Mechanical barriers do work. But it's always good to have air on your side, and please fashion your new clinic such, or at least put table fans or wall fans so you can protect yourself, your family, and your staff. Thank you.
Thank you, Samrish. Very important study, I guess, at that point of time when we had no clue of what's going on. And subsequent, I think, to your study, we also did study the aerosols directly. All of us were part of the team at NN. Where we went to ISC and studied for each one of the surgical specialties, we looked at what procedures can cause aerosol, which can reach the surgeon or the assistant, and the results were quite shocking. And we came up with guidelines like you have as to which procedure is safe for the surgeon and not. So I think going forward, even though we're probably on the downward trend for COVID, we don't know what's going to come ahead. And also an individual patient's infection itself, you don't know. So of course, this was the pandemic, but how do we know what other infection the patient had?
I think makes sense to make a clinic that is pandemic-proof or disease-proof.
Yes.
Thank you, Samrish. It was beautiful to see how the air can be picked up in these photographic systems. And we all know mask has its own advantages and very, very disadvantages also. And we all knew that right from the beginning, and started taping not only the physicians, all our patients also, especially in the OR. And some of the my OPD patient cannot enter without taping the mask, that compulsory. And many of slit lamp devices, you need to put a different modified shield. And the classical was, as we saw in the initial videos from our colleagues in the WhatsApp group, we made a double X-ray film. If you take only single X-ray film, it becomes folded. If you make a double, it's quite rigid, and you can bring little up also. So you have to put it in the oculus, and it gives both upper and down area. And that's quite a good safety, and it has to be cleaned every time. And recently we published the mask study in American Journal, where we had our health workers in the hospital. They were taped masks for 8 hours. Other group, no taping of the mask in upper airs. And we found that dry air condition were so different. And that was made compulsory subsequently, the taping of a mask has to be done. And 95, even with the, you have that little bit of a, you can say, clip, which doesn't work at all most of the time. So mask is required, but I think it should be used in a proper manner. And nicely shown, it's a beautiful images, difficult. Normally you can't see those things, you know, very good.
And I think that tendency to bring down that mask, you know, most of them are wearing the mask below the nose. So at least if you tape it, the purpose is served. I mean, it's just not a formality that we wear a mask. Half the time you see the patient is either here. So you have different levels. So at least when you tape it there, that resistance also to bring it down is not.
They'll always pull
good.
It. One thing you would have noticed, you know, our people are not, they are not comfortable. They don't know how to put their chin on a slit lamp when they are putting a mask on. They become very uncomfortable. So there has to be somebody to telling them, okay, nothing going to be wrong. You have to put like this. Because most of the time, as soon as somebody comes to meet you, first thing they'll do is they'll pull the mask down.
Before
and
taking off the glasses,
yeah.
They'll pull down, they won't take off the glasses, but they'll pull down their mask. I mean, I don't know, it's a reflex, I think.
That's a reflex. We tell every patient, one person tells only, don't remove the mask at all. But as soon as they sit in a slit lamp, they do like this, they pull and they do like this. So that teaching has to go across to patients also. Yes, okay, thank you. We can go to the next talk.